Well, Palutena, like, there's just, a lot of people that are afraid of when they fight against this character is neutral air, right? Because it racks on so much damage. But again, with Nicko, with shield. Shulk, forward, you can just hold forward air, you can hold shield and punish right afterwards. Air slash is a very devastating out of shield punish as well, so yeah. You can see that a lot. But we'll just have to see what Dabuz is going to go. He's going to opt to go for Olimar, not surprised in the least bit. But we'll see how this first game evolves, man. This would be an upset if Nicko beats Dabuz, but this could honestly go either way.
Yeah, definitely. All right, so it's going to be an exciting one. We're not going to see the Joker again. Nicko right now understands that he's in top 64 territory, 3 out of 5. The time is now. SoCal on his back, representative of Tube Scoops, rocking that Doki Doki attire, you know, which I love it, dude. Dude,
it's anime convention, man.
Exactly. The merch from Dan Salvato, a person who's from the Smash Brothers community, yeah. A person that I grew up with in Smash, too, from the Tri-State area. So here we go. Okay, so Nicko, okay, he's going with the neutral airs. He's trying to space around the bus, but catches the bus sleeping at the wheel, just blocking for far too long.
Right, and now he's got the stage control. This is where Nicko shines. He loves keeping his opponents on the ledge. Uh-oh. Right there, he kind of messed up a little bit. That's okay. Back air's going to be able to destroy the Pikmin as well as put out a large active hitbox against Olimar. Meanwhile, he got Dabuz just trying to get the right Pikmin order to go. He's already got a purple and a blue. That's what more could you ask for besides getting one more purple to boot? The blue Pikmin's going to give him the ability to be able to try to get a grab, increase knockback, and damage.
And right now, we have Smash on deck. He understands the time is now. Gets the stage spike, and there's the first stock right there.
And that's going to be really devastating for Dabuz whenever he's trying to recover like that, because Nicko can easily go off stage, connect an air slash, get the kill just like he did.
Can we talk about how big-brained it was for him to go for Smash Monado Art, though, to increase the knockback, to make it even more highly likely for Dabuz to miss the tech?
Yeah, there was just no way that he was going to get that tech. I think it was too high of knockback. There's so much damage. But now, like, another mix-up that Dabuz could potentially do in the future is try to, like, fly underneath the stage.
Yes, sir. He can totally do that. And I love the way Nicko is approaching this matchup. You see he's trying to go for cross-ups. He wants to keep catching Dabuz off guard. And Dabuz right now is just getting outspaced.
Yeah, he's playing safe, using the down tilt, connects it into a dash attack for some big damage. Buster Monado Art increasing that damage by 40%.
Dude.
Going into jump.
Dude,
combos?
He totally understands what to do in this matchup. He knows when to dash in and out of Dabuz's range. Wait, even the rolls. He's just... Has he studied Dabuz or something?
There's no way he's adapted this fast.
Yeah.
He probably was studying videos. He knew that in the projected matchup, he was supposed to fight off against Dabuz later on. So it gives you plenty of time to try to just study the boss. That's exactly what like someone the likes of Dabuz would be doing. Obstacle for shield, give himself a safe landing. He gives himself guaranteed stage control, get a shield, that purple Monado Art.
Yeah.
Or purple Pikmin, oh my god. Pushes him off stage again, 92%.
All good, Austin. Air slash!
Air slash!
There's no!
Again!
Soak!
Three stocks against Dabuz's one. He's going to try to run away with this using the speed monitor art, but good call out from Dabuz. He doesn't get too much height off of it, covering the platform landing using the purple Pikmin
exactly.
up there to get the kill.
Yep, and hearing that audio sound too, right? Just that thud, you know it was a purple for sure.
It was not good, man. There goes Jad just to get him some breathing room. That's his fastest attack that he can go for, because everything he does usually takes like 10 plus frames. He's not the fastest attacker, so when he needs like a get off me move, usually the go-to answer is like air slash or jab.
And I like that I saw Dabuz actually opt for the whistle. Wait a second. Yeah, he's going to use that to break these combos.
That was so smart because he was trying to get a combo off stage going with that, so he had to go for the whistle to use that super arm to get back onto the stage and just X-nay that combo.
Yep, very good awareness by Dabuz, but these dash attacks are doing a good job of just catching Dabuz every single time.
Nicko might be thinking about Smash Monado Art here momentarily. He still has super low percent, having trouble getting that Pikmin off him, just opts to go for the neutral air.
Yep, and Dabuz right now trying to get more active. You see, he's not being stationary anymore. He's actually trying to push his advantage every time he gets a chance.
He's throwing the white right on him, trying to force out the neutral air to get the punish right afterwards. Smart thing from Dabuz, uses the up air this time around instead of committing to the winged Pikmin because he knew Nicko was looking for an air slash. Good adaptation coming from Dabuz, but now the fast Monado Art speed coming out, pushes him off stage. Gonna look for he did dial storage right there, but doesn't even need it. Gets the forwarder, pushes him off stage. Nicko taking away game one from Dabuz.
Dude, that was insane.
And I know what Nico's game plan was right at the end. You saw him, he actually did a little dial storage right there to try to store it up in case he gets like a confirm when he gets back onto the stage.
Yeah.
Could easily get like a neutral air into an immediate swap out to Smash Power to get a combo right afterwards or something along those lines.
Yeah, I noticed there was a combo that Shulk can do that can kill at like 50 even.
If you use dial storage.
Yeah, you could get like short hop up air into into the full jump, into a, double like, jump up air.
Yeah, that's a combo. You also connect it into an air slash. There's a lot of stuff that can happen out of that. Anytime you see Nico's like Monado Arts kind of come out and then go away while he's still active in art, he's trying to store that dial so it comes out even quicker next time. That's what he's trying to accomplish in that instance.
Yeah, man. Speed Monado to Smash, I believe. Yeah, that's super
Buster
sick.
Buster to Smash is also a very popular combo. Because the decreased knockback that Monado Art Buster gives allows you to be able to confirm that into the Smash Monado Art.
Oof, and here we have it. So this is a matchup right here that I actually got a chance to see Nicko and TLTC do a couple months ago. And from what I gathered, Nicko sounded like he said that he felt like the matchup was pretty even, you know?
I believe it, dude. I think it's much better than Olimar. We saw how devastating that was for any time Olimar was off stage. Nicko was just capitalizing. Let's see. Palutena's going to have a way easier time getting back to the stage just based off of warp alone.
Yeah, man, that warp definitely helps out quite a bit. But if you notice right here, now, Dabuz, you know, it was interesting how Nicko was able to just keep capitalizing on that 45-degree angle with, like, the backers, with the forward airs, right, against Dabuz. Now things are a bit different, but at least he's facing off against a taller opponent. Warps here makes it easier for Palutena to come back on stage as opposed to Olimar.
He's a Smash Monado Art, waits for him to come back down to the stage, uses double jump, has to commit to the up B to get back onto the stage. Nico's trying to play casual. Down air?
Wow, and he got the pop-up, and there it is, the back air. Wow, Dabuz down a stock, 53% with all three stocks intact by Nicko.
Now this is Dabuz's time to shine. He's got him at 67%. You saw that.
Did you notice how Dabuz was trying to set up for an up air to catch the juggle situation that Nicko was in? But because of the air drift that he had with the speed, he couldn't catch him.
He was able to escape.
Yeah.
He's going back into Buster using the classic way to choose an arc. And now he's going to try to check on as much damage as possible. See him playing super safe, slowing down the pace a little bit, maintaining that stage control as he stays center stage.
Oh my goodness. And now, you know, with Palutena, he's going to have to deal with it. He's going to have to take all these chains of attacks. It's totally different now. Can't whistle right out of that one.
He can use the guard point off a dash attack to just try to go through the neutral air, and that's going to be a really devastating combo or just maneuver for Dabuz to try to go for, because Nicko is constantly going into the air, right?
Yes.
So we might see a lot more dash attacks coming out from Dabuz.
Uh-oh.
Gets caught by the explosive flame. That was a hearty gambit coming out from Dabuz. Puts it point blank, and because he swapped the Smash Mouth, he's able to dive.
So smart right there, and going into shield, but that allowed Nicko to get even juggled a little bit more, but cut it close afterwards. We have the jump Monado Art. I wonder what he wants to opt for this one.
Honestly, he'd just be going for some grabs, trying to toss him upwards. You see, he just wants like the extra aerial mobility.
Exactly. Okay, he gets the speed again. Dabuz, he knows when to jump early, it seems.
And Dabuz is looking for a spike right there with that down. It could have sent him flying into that blast zone. Buster Monado Art to try to attack on more and more damage. Down tilt to try to get that tech read.
Yep.
Slash, good punish, get a tech on a healthy amount of damage.
Yep, and you saw him try to land with the backer, but it wasn't going to work. Okay, he had to delay that recovery because that drop zone neutral air, it's a big threat. F tilt.
Baseball swing, knocking it out of the park, putting Dabuz to his third and final stock.
Okay, let's see the landing here. Again, Speed Monado Art is the name of the game.
Okay, good spot dodge. Going to be able to toss him out there. Let's see if Dabuz can try to capitalize on this. Jumping out of our shirt, Shulk's pretty difficult to try to like get an edge guard against, though.
As you saw, it looked like he jumped potentially into the explosive flame, but then he dipped right below to get that air slash back on safely. Speed is back on tech. Okay.
Neutral air, a very common combo starter for Speed Monado Art.
Wait. Okay, he won't go for those crazy combos we've seen from the other Shulks. Dude, I've seen him do like fair chains into the air slash off stage.
He's thinking about it, though. He does have a stock lead. Maybe he's trying to save him for like a later gambit.
Maybe. Keeping it safe might be the better play anyway, because right now he gets to keep the stock and rack up more damage.
He might also be trying to download what Dabuz is going to try to go for offstage and use that for a later data. Because if he whiffs, then he just throws away a stock.
And it is a 3 out of 5.
Yeah.
Okay,
so
here we go.
Way more in the set happening on here. Here we go. Dabuz bringing it back. Connects to neutral air. Going to be able to get some big damage off of this. Force out the shield. Monado Art doesn't even care. Continues the onslaught of damage. And just like that, we have ourselves an even game.
There it is. Speed is out. But again, that invincibility from the dash attack. Quick startup, too. But there it is. Speaking of quick startup, that neutral air out of shield. But the good thing about playing against Palutena, if you stay center stage, right, you actually have an easier time not getting KO'd. Because and also, if you're outside of that neutral air combo range, when you get hit by it, you'll just get right back into neutral. And seeing all the tools that Nicko has, he can get himself right back into the fray, as you can see here with the Speed Monado Art.
Yeah, anything that gives you like that higher mobility, man. You can usually just find yourself back into the center stage, try to shield these neutral airs. Not going to apply too much shield pressure because Shield Monado Art does increase the health of your shield.
Yep. It is again, staying at a wow.
Dude, how did he scoop under like that?
Dude, the rage.
Two scoops.
Nicko. Okay, he's not going to get KO'd here. Again, staying in center. It's a big boon.
Dabuz trying to get that neutral air off stage. That probably would have been the game. Smash Mario Art, super scary. Goes for the back air because he was in Smash Mario Art. Gonna increase his own self knockback. Dabuz finding his mark with the back air, bringing it back with Palutena. We got ourselves a 1-1 game in this first race to 3.
Yeah, I have to say, Nicko right there probably needs to remember that if you hit your opponents in this game, right, they're gonna be back turned, right? So when you, that's good for Palutena. Because if she's in disadvantage as she tries to land, she could just sneak out the back air at the very last second upon landing to put especially space to keep herself safe. So right there, I guess Nicko probably didn't expect it because we didn't really see Dabuz swing upon landing as much, especially using that back air, saving that in the back pocket till the very last second. Nicko, if he knew that was coming, that could have been a vision, you know? Yeah. And also, because of the fact that Dabuz didn't use air dodge as he was landing, I wonder if Nicko was probably thinking about using maybe Air Slash. Like, there's so many different things that he could have used upon landing. Even waiting for Dabuz to land, dashing back away from a potential swing, and then forward smashing, there's so many tools that he could use. Because the back air did get nerfed in terms of how many frames of invincibility that it has that are active, right? It's still a good tool, but you have to be way more accurate now with the times that you want to throw it out. Regardless, though, we have Shulk versus Palutena here again. Nicko shaking his head, making me feel like probably knows what to do in this third game.
Honestly, it's very reminiscent of Ally, honestly. Every time Ally wins or loses a game, he's always shaking his head. And I see Nicko doing that as well. Just wasn't really too satisfied with the matchup. If he ends up losing this game as well to Dabuz, I could kind of see him wanting to opt to try Joker out.
Wow,
as well.
Okay.
It could be a potential counter pick.
I really feel like it did pretty good in the second game,
to
be quite honest.
It was super close. Yeah. Just stick with the try and true Shulk, honestly.
Okay.
There you go. He wants to get rid of all platforms. I'm kind of shocked Dabuz didn't ban FD.
And Final Destination,
yeah.
You think he knows?
I don't know, because like Palutena gets so much off of platforms just in general that like they're just not as good on FD. But hey, you know, Shulk also likes platforms, so that might be his mentality why he went up to the go for that. Smash Bros. Is going to increase the knockback on that back throw again.
That's why it was
a double-edged sword.
It was very smart for Dabuz to keep going for those pummels just to guarantee that KO. But I will say, as a Palutena player, Palutena on this stage, it means, at least for me, that when I go for my Nair Chains, that it doesn't get interrupted by the platforms. Because there are times where Nair Chains can get messed up by the platforms.
Or now they're getting messed up by Shieldman out of war. You see him trying to escape out of those combos. He only got 18 damage off of the neutral air, when usually Palutena's getting like 35 to 50. Buzz from Nadawar going to increase the amount of damage, abusing him offstage of Porters. This is looking like an adapted gameplay coming out from Dabuz, man.
Yes, it is.
Going off super deep just to try to scare him. Smash from Nadawar.
Didn't get the two frame.
And Dabuz actually hold on to the invincibility on the ledge for like the maximum amount of time. You saw how long he hung out there because Nicko was looking to try to get the Porter on the stage. Again,
there's the back air.
Mm-hmm. He's using the back air to try to like catch the landing right behind him as well.
That was very smart. Just landing right in front of him just to get the F tilt to keep the advantage. Respecting that neutral air and Dabuz holding the shield for extra amount of time. And understanding that with the 12 frames of landing lag that neutral air has, you don't want to swing immediately and keep yourself open.
That was a pretty brave ledge attack from Dabuz. Like, he had Smash Mario where that forward air definitely would have killed that connected. We saw it happen. Went for the challenge. Air slash had a shield.
Unsafe.
Not get the kill though.
Very smart. Nicko knows his frame data for sure.
That was like a little bit of a flub right there. He's hoping for like a roll on stage. You saw him start up that run.
Trying to go deep off stage again. Oh wait, that's definitely a punish right there. Dabuz. Yeah. Seeing Nicko go off stage, I guess he probably thought he could intercept him by using a double jump with the explosive flame, but didn't work out.
Yeah, an explosive flame has so much cooldown right afterwards, so he left himself wide open for an air slash. Mm-hmm.
Aren't we fortunate that that's not unblockable in this game? Goodness gracious.
I'd be tight, man.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Gets the forward air, puts him in speed man out of art. Good call out from Dabuz. He knew exactly that Nicko wanted to just, because he has speed man out of art, his main goal was to use the horizontal distance to just come to the stage immediately, come up with an aggressive option. Dabuz calling it out with an up smash, shows him the light.
And now Dabuz is just sitting on the lead really well. But immediate switch right there. Dabuz might go for a grab. Yep, so smart.
Good adaptation. He goes for the reset. Attacking on 55 damage instead of 65. Guys, he's 75. Gets back onto the stage. Nicko is very hungry for this neutral air. He gets so much damage off of it, so I don't blame him in the slightest. There he goes. It begins.
Okay, gets his chains and Buster. We're trying to get added damage here.
Yeah, you'll see Nicko want to swap over to Buster, the more damaging Minotaur, whenever he has his opponent cornered like that.
Exactly.
He has a lot of stage control. That's when he can start to pile on the damage bit by bit.
I like that attempt at the fourth throw dash attack, but the Buzz looks like he DI'd appropriately so he can get the block. Fortunately, in this version of the game, if you block Explosive Flame, you don't have to worry about half your shield going away.
Okay, here we go. For the forward tilt, going to be able to shield grab through that neutral air, pushes him off stage. He needs this kill now or never. He wants to bring this back because it's already sitting at 98% on his final stock.
Yep, catches the roll there. Dabuz keeping it safe.
Could have been an opportunity for an air slash. You see, again, Dabuz just going for the roll away after he gets the bear. Catches all, calls out the ledge jump, shows him the light yet again with an up smash. Dabuz putting yet another point on the board as our hero Nicko, you know, struggling a little bit to try to find an answer for this Palutena.
Yeah, I have to say, dude, this switch was definitely the switch. It's crazy how many people right now, though, are all grouped together watching to see what Nicko will do here against the Buzz. They were really, really impressed with how he played against the Buzz's Olimar, but now that the Palutena's out, things are different, man. What were you going
to
say?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cut you off, but just, there's so much on the line.
There is.
There's like a winner of this moves on the top 32, winner's side.
Yep.
That's something you always got to keep in mind. This would be a really good win for Nicko to try to move on Bragg and try to prove himself. This is like, I would say this could be Nico's breakout performance if he takes this W.
Of course. Representing Demise right here. Nicko, what stage did we just see there? Was it Battlefield?
I believe he picked Battlefield. I might be missing. I wasn't really looking. I was too busy focusing on his eyes because he's just like, you see how like drained he looked. He looks like, I don't want to say he looks defeated right now, but something's going through his mind. He needs a different change of game plans here.
Yeah.
Dabuz is adapting to what he's doing really strongly.
Yeah. Hopefully he gets to dig into the prior experience he's had against previous Palutenas. You know, TLTC, who, big shout out to a man. You know, I know he's dealing with, like, family stuff right now, so we haven't been seeing him enter tournaments recently.
Right.
But going into this match, here it is. Game four situation. Dabuz versus Nicko.
And there we go, just right out the gate. You see Nicko had a lot of stage control there, pushing to the corner immediately, but Dabuz is so good at escaping that corner, using Explosive Flame point blank, showing that he has no fear to just throw that out there, because it forces the shield out, and if you don't, it pushes you completely out of that stage corner.
Yep, and I do like one thing from Nicko. He's using a lot more dash to try to outspace Dabuz, but Dabuz has been also using that to his advantage, right? He kind of pushed forward and overshot with the dash attack. So, yeah, Nico's going to have to keep it unpredictable right there.
That's the key of the game, man. You got to try to be as unpredictable as possible, play as safe as possible, go for more punish game. And I think that's what Nico's trying to do here. He's waiting for Dabuz to make that first move before going for like the air slash, holding shield a lot more.
But right there, getting caught for the destroy on that neutral air. Trying to keep that advantage going right here. Dabuz, yes, to respect that warp recovery. Okay.
Going to avoid the explosive flame, going back into jumping out of art. Looking to find his mark. You see him jumping back and forth. Goes for the reverse neutral air, because when Shulk throws that neutral air, it comes out faster from behind. That's when the active hitbox starts. Go over the backslash, go out onto the ledge. Very brave of him.
And we didn't even see him. Wow, that was... Wait a second.
Apply some shield pressure, give himself some breathing room. Goes for the ledge attack again. I feel like Dabuz has been doing that a lot this game, and this set in general.
Speaking of things that Dabuz has been doing a lot, like the overshoots that we saw, even on the neutral air to catch Nicko when he wants to go for the back airs, right? He's spacing back air, and then Dabuz would just nair it immediately. Okay, nair?
Smash Mount of Art, go for the grab. What is happening?
He's stealing his spot dodge,
spot
too.
Spot dodge four times in a row?
Dabuz just waited, biding his time. No fares.
Because what Nicko wanted to do, he wanted Dabuz to go for an attempt to grab so he could punish it with an air slash. That's what his game plan was. But you saw how patient Dabuz was right there. Didn't commit to it. Now he's getting these ladder combos off the top platform.
I was about to say, yeah, that could be a tough spot if he actually fell into another up air.
Well, that was actually a mix-up from Dabuz. He actually went for the explosive flame
because
he was hoping that Nicko was going to drift away to avoid a potential another up air.
Precisely.
Okay, forward air, pushes it back off stage. Completely doable for Nicko if he closes out this stock. Playing super safe, just goes for the forward air, active hitbox, catches the ledge get up, but also beat out ledge attack, which Dabuz has been going for a lot.
And right there, taking that down throw bear with the shield Minotaur War, allowing him to stay alive. And now here's his chance to get something started. Using the Buster, has Dabuz cornered. Combo time, Dabuz using well-timed defensive mechanisms just to get out of that situation.
Dabuz has been doing spot dodges a lot as well. Every single time Nicko goes over to approach him, baits out the air dodge, whips the forward air because the jump Minotaur War gave him a little bit too much vertical control. neutral air, trying to bait out these shields again. Good parry out of that. You can actually kind of react to his aerial attack sometimes when they come out so slow.
Wow, and getting the backer, which actually puts him off stage, but great spacing right there, using the backslash to get in the fray. And
catches the ledge.
Okay, the buzz right there with the whiff on the forward air, allowing him, Nicko, to just get that punish right there.
Going for the empty hop, gets the shield grab, pushing it back off stage, going for the buzzer, try to rack up as much damage as possible, catches the roll.
Oh, yes. That's a lot,
96, 114, smash round art. If he catches his forward air, he can easily
make
this into the final
that
stock.
That was an opening, but he gets the grab here.
I think that was a habit from Smash 4 for Nicko. They went for down throw, because I think forward throw might have potentially killed there.
But he gets the KO regardless because the buzz couldn't jump.
There we go, finally finds himself with the lead against the Palutena. It's 130%, gonna hold on shield and art so he doesn't die there for just a split second. Obviously a smart thing while your opponent's invincible for like 2 seconds.
Yep. Oh, and he gets the neutral air, but it's not going to be the end. One more, we'll get the KO this time.
There it is. No matter what, he had the jump and out of ward, so he got a lot of aerial mobility, which is why he's able to go back out there without a double jump. But Dabuz just playing calm, getting these neutral airs even. Sees the shieldman out of art, he knows to adapt his combo mid-combo when he goes for the shieldman out of art. That's how you have to deal with that gimmick.
Yeah, a lot of times these players, they tend to DI in, which allows the bus to go for the up air conversions after the neutral air too. Wait a second. Okay, opportunity here.
Let's see if he can try to make as most of it as he can. He's not opting to go for a out of art right now.
I was waiting for Buster, honestly, Austin.
Yeah. I was saying that.
There it is.
Speak of the devil. There it is. And Buzz has been rolling past Nicko every single time, almost.
Mm-hmm.
Every time he has a corner like that. I feel like he's pressured to do it. I wonder when Nico's going to finally capitalize on that. Rapid jab going to be able to switch over to shield and out of ward to take the minimal amount of damage afterwards. Ledge attack. Buzz going to capitalize on it. Forces out to jump.
Yep, but
the explosive flame.
There it is. Nicko actually getting back on stage to spacing. Catching the spot dodge again with the neutral air. Some of the active frames. Gets a knockdown, though.
Just goes right back in with the dash attack. Nico's trying to go off stage, gets the cross up. No punish coming out from Dabuz. Sitting at 134%, he's got to play safe, trying to space out these neutral airs so we can't get a big punish from Dabuz. Pushes him back off stage, busts from Nador to try to rack up as much damage as possible. Looking for the neutral airs, get the dash attack right afterwards. We see a smash from Nador. Looking for the kill back air.
He wants to end it right now. Will he be able to get it if Dabuz just seizes center immediately?
He turns it off. He didn't believe in it. Back air, jumping out of art, has to get back to stage.
Up smash. There it is.
He was thinking about it.
Okay, he could smart move, going for Shulk, a little out of range for the grab.
See, trying to space out the aerials as well. That's not gonna kill. Actually it did! The shield matter wore off, gets above there, using the double jump to avoid certain doom, gets caught by the drop down neutraler, and Dabuz bringing that back 3-1. He's gonna pop off a little bit because that was a scary set for